how we can become involved with OCC at the area level. So put that on your calendars there for next Sunday. All right, let's get to singing. All right, Brother Isaiah.
Good morning, brethren. We will start our responsive reading on 499. So if y'all would please stand in honor of Christ and open your hymnals to 499. This is titled Freedom and Victory. 499. 499. Okay. For this is what love for God is, to keep his commands. Now his commands are not a burden, because whatever has been born of God conquers the world.
This is the victory that has conquered the world, our faith. And who is the one who conquers the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God?
In all these things we are more than victorious through him who loved us.
Today you are about to engage in battle with your enemies. Do not be faint-hearted. Do not be afraid, alarmed, or terrified because of them. For the Lord your God is the one who goes with you, fighting for you against your enemies, to give you victory.
What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? Amen. He did not even spare his own son, but offered him up for us all. He will not, how will he not also with him grant us everything?
Thanks be to God who gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Well, friends, let's turn back to hymn number 68, Holy, Holy, Holy. We are doing all four verses with a key change between 3 and 4.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty.
friends. Let's turn almost all the way to the back to 493. 493. This is Revive Us Again. Excuse me. And we're only doing three of the four verses, so let's do 1, 2, and 3. Make it easy. 1, 2, and 3. Go ahead.
Do not adjust your set at this time, please. We are experiencing technical difficulty.
This moment of silence was brought to you by your former playground.
Absolutely.
You know what? Let's do something different right here. We have with us our sent missionaries, Bill and Laura Dewey, and they have been able to be with us for the last few weeks in church, but they are about to take off back to the mission field. So I'm sitting here as the video isn't working, and I'm thinking, North American, okay, here we go. We've got some missionaries right here in our midst, and when you give, of course, part of the offering does go to fund the missionaries who are going to places where there may be no gospel presence whatsoever. So right here, why don't we have a special word of prayer for our two missionaries as they head back to the mission field, and then we'll have the ushers come and we'll receive the morning offering. Would you join me? Father, as a church, we just want to put our faith together right now and just pray, Father, for an open door for the gospel. We pray for the power of your Spirit, Father, to accompany Phil and Laura on the mission field. Everywhere they go, Father, I pray that his testimony would just shine, that people would see Jesus in them, and that they would be able to lead many of the lost to you. We can't wait to hear the report back, Father, of all the great experiences that they had. Keep them safe, Father. Thank you for all the work that you've done in healing Phil's body. And we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, that's called calling off.
Come and worship you in this house, Lord, in your house, Lord. Lord, for this weather, for this beautiful sunshine we have today. Lord, we just thank you for all the many blessings that you give us, Lord. And we just ask that you take these blessings and these offerings, Lord, and use them to your will, Lord, in your loving name. Amen.
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 All right, dear friends, you can remain seated for this hymn. If you would, though, please turn to hymn number 46. This is My Father's World. And just now kind of reminded me of our Sunday school lesson this morning. We were talking about faith, and the scriptures were in Luke where Christ is telling us not to worry. And, you know, with that, this is our Father's world. He has sovereignty over it. We can rest in that sovereignty, knowing that He has everything under His control. So, let's not to worry. All right, go ahead. Church. Be good.